Hi guys, how are you doing today? Welcome back to Random Lifestyle Vlog. It's time for my monthly empties and let me just show you the items I used up in November. So there you go, not as many as I expected, but it is what it is. So without further ado, let's just jump in. So I'm going to start with Bath & Body products. I have a couple of sets here. So this one is by Aran and this is Glen Eorsa Lavender and Spearmint. This does smell so good. This is such a calming fragrance. And like pretty much everything done by Aran, this gives me this kind of like outdoorsy vibe. So yeah, it is beautiful. Next up we have some Elemis. So this is Elemis Bath and Shower Milk in Neroli Blossom. And then we have a matching body cream. This smells so good. And I love the formula of these like body creams. It's just so lush. The fragrance composition here is a little bit more unique. It's not this kind of like sunny, uplifting neroli. It's quite earthy, I would say. It's earthy, it's a little bit creamy. So very, again, very kind of relaxing fragrance. It is beautiful. So another product from kind of like Bath & Body category is this Pure by Mud Musky. And this is a scrub for underarms. So you just kind of like scrub your armpits with it. And this is supposed to, it says here, reduces dark appearance, removes dead skin cells, odor fighting, deeply cleansing, reduces pesky bumps. So generally it's supposed to be used like instead of a deodorant. And it does work to some extent like that. I'm not really sure about the dark appearance or like other things that are mentioned here. But as a deodorant or instead of a deodorant, it does work to some extent. It's not something I would trust like 100%. When I'm in a stressful situation in the gym, or I don't know, when it's very hot. But if you're just staying at home and not doing anything in particular, this does work. So yeah, it was quite an interesting product to use, something I've never actually tried before. And then we're going to finish this Bath & Body category with some hand products. So we have Margaret Dabbs and this is hand serum, which is pretty much a lighter hand cream. That's how I would describe it. It was very nice. Next up we have Clarins and this is hand and nail treatment cream. There you go. Again, a very nice product. Not something I'll probably repurchase, but it was, you know, it was good. And then we have Grown Alchemist, and this is a hand cream with vanilla and orange peel, and this one smelled so good. I'm actually really glad because I have a backup tube of this cream, so yeah. Because that's really good, because otherwise I would have to repurchase it. Okay, next up we have a couple of, like, scented products. So we have a neon candle, and this is a scent to make you happy with neroli, mimosa, and lemon. This is probably my favorite neon candle. It's just so uplifting and bright. I love it. By the way, I don't really show you like every single candle I use up. I just show you the ones that usually appear in like advent calendars and only the ones that are in full size. So yeah, that's that. Here we have another scented product and this is by, I'm not really sure how to pronounce this brand. Is it Dr. Vranjes? I'm not really sure. So this is like a home fragrance and this one is in Scent Milano. Such a beautiful fragrance. I really love these home sprays. They literally fill the home room with a fragrance that is like perfume quality. So it's not the kind of like a room spray, like a typical room spray that you would get in a supermarket. This is like a really nice perfumey scent, really lovely. Okay, I just realized we have like one more body product over here and this is Joe by Joe Loves body cream. It was nice. It actually lasted me for quite a while, although Joe by Joe Loves is my least favorite Joe Loves fragrance. So okay, time for a hair product. So we have some Elasticizer by Philip Kingsley. I love this product and this appears in my empties quite often. That pretty much shows how much I use it. And then we have a Super Strength Treatment Mask by Fekai. And this was so good. This smelled dreamy, so I loved it for that mostly. But it actually worked really nicely on my hair. And this is one of those hair masks that you only keep for, I think it's like 3 minutes. Let me just see. Yeah. 3 to 4 minutes. So even if you don't have time, this is like a really nice treatment. So yeah, I really like that one. All right, so I don't have any makeup items this time. So this is our last category and this is skincare. So first up, some Augustinus Bather. And this is not the rich cream, this is the cream. So this one is a little bit lighter. I use it as a day cream because it's like lightweight enough. And I generally use the rich cream as my night cream. So yeah, this was a really lovely cream. I actually have a massive stash of the rich version, the classic one. it's probably a little bit more usable for like most people, but like for some reason we don't really get these in advent calendars, we get the rich version. So I mean, it is what it is. Oh well, I mean, at least this is a good cream. So next up we have some Lumen, and this is Nordic Sea Overnight Bright Sleeping Cream. And this is what it looks like. So yeah, this was a really lovely cream. I did not use it too often because I usually apply retinols in my evening kind of like skincare routine, and this actually contains vitamin C. So since you shouldn't mix products with vitamin C with retinol products, I never used it on my retinol days. I only used it on my acid days, so like once or twice a week I would apply glycolic or lactic acid on my skin, and then I would just top it up with this cream after it kind of like sinks in my skin. Next up we have Bulgarian Rose Satin Cream by Hamish. This is a Korean brand. I really like this cream. It was quite rich, but not too heavy for my skin, and it did leave this kind of like a glowy finish. So yeah, it was very nice. Next up we have Albiva, and this is Hydration Booster. So literally a hydrating serum. I use hydration serums every single day. I don't really think you need to pay a lot of money for that, so this was just as good as like any hydrating serum for me. Yeah, that's that. And as far as I know, this brand is pretty expensive, so I'm guessing the serum was too. Next product is by Decléor, and this is Eucalyptus Sika Botanic Mask. And this mask is supposed to be restoring for dry and delicate skin. And yeah, I liked it. It's very kind of like calming and soothing. So it was a really nice one. So next up we have a Jorgobe Hyaluronic Acid Serum. Same story, like hyaluronic acid serums are like a must in my skincare routine. But I don't really mind what I use. Like as long as it's hydrating and that as long as it doesn't feel weird on my skin, I'll just use anything. So yeah, can't really tell much difference between like separate hyaluronic acid serums. They feel very similar to my skin. Next up we have Boehm 27, and this is Bioenergizing Cell Repair Balm. This one was really good. This is something I would use overnight, and it does make my skin look really lovely in the morning. So yeah, that one was good. Next up we have Biossans, and this is Squalane and Hyaluronic Toning Mist. It's just like a mini size, but this was a really lovely product. Oh, this one is actually pretty cool. This is Neom Perfect Night Sleep Face Oil with cranberry seed oil, apricot kernel oil, and almond oil. And this, the scent of this oil was just so relaxing and calming. I loved it. I used it just before my bedtime. Usually around that time, my kind of like anything I put on my face kind of like sink in and absorbs. So I just need a little top up, and this was just perfect. Very soothing, very calming, perfect just before your bedtime. Next one is Zellens, and this is Power C Vitamin C Concentrate. It was a really nice, quickly absorbing vitamin C serum. Then we have Grown Alchemist, and this is enzyme exfoliant with papain and amino complex. So this is what it looks like. I really liked it, although it was very gentle. I have sensitive skin, but this was so gentle that I wasn't even sure if this is really doing any exfoliation to my skin. Very gentle. If you have super sensitive skin, you can definitely try that one out. And then lastly, we have Audacité, and this is Pure Elements Wild Carrot Serum Concentrate Vital Glow. So this tiny bottle is actually a full-size product. You just add 2 to 3 drops and you just mix it with your cream. And I really enjoyed it. It does have this really nice scent to it, and it literally makes my skin look more glowy. I really like that. I do have a couple more of those like booster serums. I need to kind of like find them. And I definitely want to test some more of these. Okay guys, so these are my November empties. What do you think? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Thank you very much for watching. For more beauty related content, check those videos over here. I'm going to see you very soon. Take care, bye.